Welcome everyone. Today in this video lecture, we will discuss about the seepage analysis and seepage line. In this video, we will discuss about the seepage line, characteristics of seepage line, need of prediction of seepage line, seepage analysis, seepage discharge through isotropic soil, determination of phreatic line when the dam section is homogeneous and provided with a horizontal filter. In this, these all topics will be covered in two or three videos, but in this video we will discuss about these three topics, that is seepage line, characteristics and need. Now seepage line. In seepage analysis, we have to know the two terms. The first term is permeability and the second term is seepage. So we should know the difference between these two. Suppose this is a soil sample. These are the solid particles and this is the void between the particles. If these particles are interconnected, then this soil sample will allow the water to flow through it. So this is a property of the soil. So we can say permeability is a property of material by which water can flow through the soil. Now seepage, if water is flowing through the soil sample, then this process is known as seepage. If this soil permits the flow of water through it, then this property of soil will be known as permeability, and if water is flowing through the voids of the soil, then this process will be known as seepage. It is the line within the dam section below which soil is saturated and there are positive hydrostatic pressure in the dam. Suppose this is a dam made of earthen material and this material is pervious in nature. And here is the water. Then what will happen? The water will start flowing through the body of the dam and it will flow towards the downstream side. Now this line is called seepage line. This seepage line cuts the downstream face of dam at this point. This point is above the earth surface. So the part below this seepage line will be fully saturated and the part of dam above this seepage line, this part will be dry or moist. Along the seepage line, the pressure is atmospheric. Means seepage line pe kaun sa pressure hoga? Atmospheric pressure ke equal hoga. And there is positive hydrostatic pressure below this seepage line. Above this seepage line, there is a zone of capillary. There is a capillary zone, and in this capillary zone the hydrostatic pressure is negative. This seepage line is also known as phreatic line or saturation line or top flow line. So these are about the seepage line. Now the characteristics of seepage line. At starting point, it is normal to upstream face of dam, which is an equipotential line. जब ये seepage line यहाँ से start होती है, तब ये upstream face के साथ क्या है? Perpendicular है यहाँ पे 90 degree पे होगी. And the face of dam is a equipotential line. Means equipotential line कौन सी होती है जिसपे एक ऐसी line जिसके हर एक point पे पोटेंशियल मीन्स प्रेशर हेड इक्वल हो, तो उसको बोलते हैं इक्विपोटेंशियल लाइन. इट ड्रॉप्स वर्टिकली इन ए हॉरिजॉन्टल फिल्टर. To reduce the seepage, I have provided here a filter. Due to this, this seepage line will not cut the downstream face of dam. Now it will drop in this filter vertically. The pressure along phreatic line is atmospheric. The presence of pervious stratum below the dam does not influence the position of seepage line. अगर इस ये जो डैम का बॉटम है इसके नीचे का मटेरियल ये मटेरियल अगर परवियस हो परवियस मीन्स ऐसा मटेरियल जो अपने अंदर से वाटर को पास होने दे अगर ये परवियस मटेरियल के ऊपर बना हुआ है डैम तो ये सीपेज लाइन पे कोई इफेक्ट नहीं करेगा. फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ द लेंथ द सीपेज लाइन कोइंसाइड्स विद द बेस पैराबोला. When we determine the phreatic line through the dam provided with horizontal filter or other cases, then we should know that this seepage line coincides with the base parabola. Means जो seepage line है वो base parabola की property को use करती है. उसी के according seepage line हम determine कर सकते हैं. तो जितनी भी seepage line की length है उसकी most of the length किसको कोइंसाइड करेगी बेस पैराबोला को कोइंसाइड करेगी. सो व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन दिस सीपेज लाइन कट्स द डाउनस्ट्रीम फेस अबव द बेड ऑफ द डैम देन वाटर विल स्टार्ट्स फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम दिस साइड बिलो दिस सैचुरेशन लाइन. इट विल डिक्रीज द डेंसिटी ऑफ सॉइल पार्टिकल्स. इफ द डेंसिटी ऑफ सॉइल पार्टिकल्स डिक्रीजेज it also decreases the shear strength of soil. Shear strength of soil decreases, its bearing capacity will also decrease. So we have to determine the seepage line, we have to do the seepage analysis of dam. Now the need of prediction of seepage line. To obtain the top boundary line for drawing flow net, suppose this is the dam and here is the water, the head of water is H, then this is a seepage line, this is another flow line, this is another flow line. Okay, so the top line is known as seepage line. So to draw the flow net, this top line will help us to draw the flow net. Ensure that it does not cut the downstream face much above the toe of dam. This point is called toe of dam. तो हमें ये देखना होगा कि जो सीपेज लाइन है वो अपस्ट्रीम फेस को ज़्यादा डिस्टेंस पे कट तो नहीं कर रही है. Next, to obtain the dividing line between dry soil and saturated soil to carry out stability analysis. सीपेज लाइन को डिटरमाइन करने के बाद हमें क्या मिलता है, हमें दो पार्ट्स मिलते हैं डैम के. इसके नीचे वाला पार्ट है दैट इज सैचुरेटेड और इसके ऊपर वाला पार्ट है दैट इज़ ड्राई पार्ट. तो स्टेबिलिटी एनालिसिस करने में हमें इससे हेल्प मिलती है.